So, good evening students, Sherina, Imam Hussain and Netra. Now, we will move on to the third chapter named periodic table. Already we have given brief introduction, it got stuck up. Once again, let me briefly introduce. So, in the first previous two chapters, we have studied about the concept, basic concepts of chemistry and also a structure of atom model. Next is the aspect of there are about 120 elements in the earth crust identified so far. Good evening, Sandosh, Bhavani and Damien. Gunasegar also. Midun, Karthik, Gunasegar, Srivatsan, Krishna Swami. So everybody please, good evening. Now we will move on to the classification of elements based on periodicity or concept of periodic table. Period means an event which can be taking place in the regular intervals of time. In your max, sine function, cos function, all the trigonometric functions are called periodic functions. Pulakit, good evening. Dhanalakshmi, good evening. So, all these are periodic functions, means all the trigonometric functions will vary up to a period of 2 pi radians or 360 degree. After 360 degree, once again the values get repeated. So if the properties are repeated after some regular intervals, that is called periodicity. So now we will see the aspect of periodicity in the elements. So our topic, this aim of this chapter is classification of the elements and periodicity in the properties of the elements. Now before going to the chapter, each of you have a glance over the thing. What is the necessity for periodic table? What is the necessity for? So, is alphabet necessary to learn any language? Yes, of course. Without alphabet, we cannot. Even if you start any language, first alphabets will be taught. Then only you can communicate through speaking, writing, reading, etc. So forth. So this alphabet is necessary to, is it necessary to learn language? Yes or no? Definitely it is yes. Alphabets are necessary to learn any language. For example, we have different languages. Each language, Telugu, Tamil, Hindi, whatever be the case, we want the respective alphabets to be studied first. So language study first starts with the study of alphabets. Here also, study of elements starts with the periodic table, periodic classification. That is the necessity. So, English alphabets. We need English alphabets to learn English. And also, from A to Z, every word starting from the respective letter will be given at the start to have an idea. So, without the alphabets, language cannot be studied. And also without periodic table or periodicity, elements, their properties cannot be studied. That is the idea. So the classification of elements, periodicity, plays the basic role of alphabet in the language study. So next, based on this fact, scientists considered chemistry as a language. They considered chemistry as the language and periodic table as its alphabet. So they arranged all the elements in certain tabular form. This is called periodic table. So table means anything in max, matrices you might have studied, rows and columns. If you are not studied, let us revise. Matrix is an array of elements arranged in rows and columns. The horizontal running species are called rows. Vertical running species are called columns. So rows and columns constitute a table. A table consists of two types of directions, rows and columns. Here also elements are arranged in the rows and columns in the form of a table. The vertical collection of elements, group of elements, they are called groups, whereas horizontal collection of elements in this chart, they are called periods. For example, hydrogen and helium, they are in the first period or first row. From lithium to neon, all the elements are in the second period. Lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, they are in the second period. Like that, sodium to argon third period, potassium to krypton fourth period, rubidium to xenon sixth period, cesium to radon seventh period. Like that, 4, 5, 6, 7 periods. Seventh period, some elements are left. They are yet to be found. We will see the naming. And also below that you have some two types of column called lanthanoids and actinoids. It is equivalent to your X, Y, Z axis. X axis is the rows. Y axis is the columns. Z axis is equivalent to lanthanoids and actinoids. Parallel lines. In this way, what is the necessity you will see. Now, it is similar to identification of elements. So, this life starts from the stage of a child, a boy or girl, and young man or lady and old man, like that. So, common growth of human being takes place at different stages. Similarly, the elements, about 120 elements have been identified in the earth crust by today, but in the 17th century end, in the year 1800 AD, only 30 elements were identified, 31 elements were identified by the scientist. In a span of 65 years afterwards, double the number of elements were observed, 63 elements. At present, 120 elements have been identified. So in all, we cannot remember all the 120 elements by name. It will be tedious. Some sort of identification of their properties, grouping them so that you can group them easily. So that is the idea. So the necessity for, so for the understanding of properties of elements, or for either easy understanding of properties of elements, elements are classified in a systematic manner. So this already we have seen objectives of this lesson. Important objectives of this lesson: understanding of need for classification of elements and understanding of present form of periodic table, classification of elements as S block, P block, D block and F block, and the characteristics of respective block elements, S block elements, P block elements, D block elements. So already we have seen that chemistry is of three types: physical chemistry, inorganic chemistry, organic chemistry. Organic chemistry is the chemistry of carbon compounds, carbon and hydrogen compounds. Inorganic chemistry is the chemistry of elements other than carbon, preferably. So other than carbon and hydrogen combination. So all other elements will be studied here. So S block elements, P block elements, D block elements, F block elements, you will be studying in this course in the 2 years in the inorganic chemistry. S block and P block this year, D block and F block next year. So all these are learn their main characteristic. This is the aim of this chapter. Lastly, we have told periodicity. What is mean by periodic trend? Periodic trend means repetitive nature in the properties. Repetitive nature in the properties. Similar to, for example, sine 30 is equal to half. What is sine 390? Anybody can tell? Sine 390? Sine 390 is nothing but sine of 360 plus 30. 360 you can rule out. Once again, it is also sine 30. So whatever, so sine 390 is also off, sine 30 is also off. So this property, all these sine functions are periodic with respect to 360 degree or 2 pi radians. Here also, elements have similar properties, repetitive properties after certain regular intervals. Understanding the that trend in properties is the next aim, I think. Now, how periodic classification was generated? What is the source? Genesis, first production. Production, it does not exactly mean the production. Starting, how it was evolved. How periodic classification was evolved. What is the necessity to classify the elements? About 120 elements we cannot remember. The group, some extent we can remember the whole aspects. So, whenever the number increases, we will try to remember only in groups. So, number individual 1 or 2 or 3 people individually, they will be called by names. So, about 100 or 200 people, they will be classified into this group, that group, like that. So, classification into groups makes the remembrance and identification understanding easy. So, 114 elements are there. It is difficult to study all elements at a time. So, if we group them, we can group them. What are metals? What are non-metals? You can give example. So, you can know the individual example even if we cannot remember all the elements in nature. By the sight, for example, in max, anybody can write, for example, I am telling, what is the number next to 1 lakh? Everybody will be tempted to tell 1 lakh plus 1, 1 lakh and 1, like that. So, we cannot count every time. So, if you have a glance of the possibilities and concept in this, you can always tell the answer. So, it is necessary to understand the properties of the elements so that they are easily classified and systematically. Classified systematically. So, that is the reason. So, now first classification of elements. Classification of elements. So, elements were grouped in the form of three elements put together or eight elements put together and some other higher number of elements put together in the form of rows and columns. And lastly, how they are arrangement, how they are arranged, grouped in the form of periods and groups. So, last three arrangements, arrangements in the form of periods and groups. Period is a horizontal row of elements. Horizontal, everybody to remember. So, period means in this chapter. Generally, you period means you refer to time, 50 minutes, 45 minutes, 1 hour, whatever be the case. In max period means periodic function means 2 pi or whatever be the case. In this subject, period means horizontal row of elements. Similarly, group means vertical column of elements. Vertical column of elements. Everybody to remember these two aspects. So, first Dobereiner, scientist Dobereiner, he arranged the elements in the group of three elements. Three, it is called triad. So, he observed that these three elements, groups, three elements, they form a common property. He deduced some law. That is called a law of triads. That is nothing laws used to be. Essence of the Dobereiner law is that every three elements show some similarity. Every three elements show some similarity. That is, you will see them in detail. Whereas, next is Newland's law of octaves. He grouped the elements. Good evening, Rome. So, he grouped the elements in the form of octaves. Octaves mean, octa means eight. Octa means eight. Octahedron, eight-headed figure, eight-faced figure. So, octaves means group of eight elements showing some similarity. Newland observed that every eight elements, there is a for every group of eight elements, there is a similarity in their properties. He observed. all these went together up to certain element only, up to calcium only it went well. Afterwards it could not be predicted. Later on, Lothar Meyer, he arranged periodic table. He grouped the elements in the form of first two are only rows, row of three elements, row of eight elements. Next one, Lothar Meyer arranged periodic table. He grouped the elements in the form of rows and columns. And also some elements could not be placed. He maintained some law, could not be placed. Later on, Mendeleev, he is called pioneer of, even though Lothar Meyer arranged that, Mendeleev is called pioneer of periodic table. He observed what is the basic property in the periodic trend of elements, properties of elements. He observed that properties of all the elements are functions of their atomic weight, or functions of their atomic weight. That was his law. So Mendeleev's periodic law is that the function properties of elements are repeating with respect to the atomic weight. Atomic weight. Based on atomic weight, he arranged the elements in the form of rows and columns. Anybody having doubt in this mentioning, you can raise. You will see them in detail with the explanation once again. So Mendeleev arranged the elements in the form of groups and columns. Groups and periods, columns and rows of elements according to the increasing order of atomic weight. But there were some positive and negative points in its Mendeleev periodic table. He could predict the element whose properties are known, but during his lifetime that element was not detected. So he left some space for a particular element. This element which will be later found, discovered, will have these properties. He predicted the element, properties of the elements. He only could not find the element, identify the element, that's all. So silicon, germanium, silicon, you will see them. So he named them with some prefix, eka, eka. Eka in eka is the prefix in Greek meaning similar. So he called eka silicon, eka boron, like that. So he could predict the element. That element was not discovered during his lifetime, but he has told about the properties of the element. So child is not born, but child's characters are predicted, like that. So he has told about the, that is the peculiar aspect of Mendeleev. Even though Mendeleev has limitations, he is called pioneer of the periodic table. Lastly, modern periodic table, it was discovered by, that was proposed by scientist Moseley. So Moseley found that he modified the periodic Mendeleev's periodic law by atomic weight as atomic number. Totally similar, the properties of the elements are functions of the atomic number and not atomic weight, he has told. That's all. So now we will see them one by one. First one, Dobrynner. Dobrynner law of Dobrynner's law of triads. Triad is the collection of three elements. It is a group of three elements. He gave this law. Similar properties in several groups of three elements. Any group consists of only three elements. So he found that the property of the middle element, if you have three elements X, Y, Z like this, the property of the middle element is the average of properties of the end elements, he told. Atomic number of middle element is the average atomic number of. If this is metal, and this X is metal and Y is non-metal, he told that it will be metalloid, like that. So the properties of the middle element are the average of the end elements. That was his essence, law of triad. So according to this law, in a triad, the middle elements had the properties average to that of the first and third element, that is the end elements. First element is left hand element, third element is the right hand element. That's all. Example, he group one such triad, Dobrynia triad, is that lithium, sodium, potassium. Lithium, sodium, potassium. Here the end elements are lithium and potassium. Middle element is sodium. So he showed that the atomic weight of sodium is the average of the atomic weights of lithium and potassium. So atomic weight of sodium is 7. Atomic weight of potassium is, atomic weight of lithium is 7. Atomic weight of potassium is 39. Average of 39 and 7. 39 plus 7, 46. 46 by 2, 23. So 23 is the atomic weight of sodium. That is correct. Sodium atomic weight is 23. So similar, here he has shown the example. So here lithium, sodium, potassium is a Dobrynia triad. Dobrynia triad. So the properties of sodium are generally average of the properties of lithium and potassium. Lithium is the lightest metal, potassium is a heavier metal, sodium metal is have a medium density, like that. Another example of Dobrynia triad is that calcium, strontium, barium. Calcium, strontium, barium. Calcium atomic weight is 40 and barium atomic weight, end elements atomic weight is 137. So 177 by 2, 89, it is around 88, like that. So next triad is chlorine, bromine, iodine. Chlorine atomic weight is 35.5. All these are mentioned in your books. You can refer. Now you can listen to this slide. So this chlorine 35.5, bromine 80, iodine 127. So the atomic weight of bromine is the average of atomic weights of chlorine and iodine. So in this way he could predict three types of triads. One is lithium, sodium, potassium. Another one is calcium, strontium, barium. Third one is chlorine, bromine, iodine. These are called Dobrynia triads. Dobrynia triads. But what are the drawbacks of Dobrynia's law? Only few elements were known during his lifetime. So they follow. They too, it was difficult to arrange the elements in triads because their atomic weights will be almost same. If the atomic weights are almost same, how to arrange them in the increasing order? So you cannot. So almost means it is not exactly, and also it is not quite deviating. That is the idea. So you cannot equate. You cannot also consider that it is quite different. That is mean by almost similar. So example, iron, cobalt, nickel. So this is the example against the Dobrynia law. Hereafter, the questions will be based on your understanding. So they will ask the question. Give an example of triad against Dobrynia's law. The triad against Dobrynia's law is iron, cobalt, nickel. All these are they are metals. All these are they form triad only. But the atomic weights are almost say 56, 59, 59. So if you round off the value, iron atomic weight is 56, cobalt atomic weight is 59, nickel also 59. So cobalt and nickel, if they are of 59, how to arrange them one below other? Actually, it will be coming after. You will see them later. So it is not the arrangement. Opposite example to that of Dobrynius law. Now, so Dobrynius law was not correct with respect to the triad iron, cobalt and nickel. Iron, cobalt and nickel. Based on this, based on the just know what we have studied, some questions you can yourself try. So what is a triad? Triad is a group of 3, group of 4, group of 5 or group of 6. What is a triad? Anybody can give? Just press the number post. So what is the triad? It is a group of dash elements. 3 elements, 4 elements, good. Ganesh and Sivaparman. Good. So this Dobrynius law of triads is a triad is a group of 3 elements. Good. Stefanio and Serena. And also Pulakit Gowda. Pulakit Gowda, Dhanalakshmi, everybody. Good. Now, next question. What was the question? Nice. What was the drawback of Dobrynius law of triads? Only a few elements were known. It may or may not be. We'll check. Some elements have almost similar atomic weights. Both means both A and B. None of A and B. A is also correct. B is also correct. Only a few elements were known during the lifetime of Dobrynius. Even the known elements, some elements have iron, cobalt and nickel. How? Good. Can't debunk. So, cobalt and nickel have same atomic, similar atomic weight of 59. We have seen. So, answer C is the correct choice. Good. Nice of you. Ganesan and Pulakit Gowda. So, both only a few elements were known and also it was difficult to arrange the elements because of their similarity in the atomic weights. Atomic weight. Next question. Next concept is the Newland's law of octaves and lower period. Octave is the collection of 8 elements as a row. Whereas Lothar-Meyer periodic table is a collection of array of elements arranged in the rows and columns. We will see them. So, Newland's law of octaves. According to what is meant by octave? Collection of 8 elements. Collection of 8 elements. It is similar to, so, in your any flute or any tones, notes, music, vocal, Carnatic, classical, any type of music, there are 7 notes. Sa, Ri, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 notes. 7 note. Hindustani music or classical music, they will sing only in this collection of these notes only. So, 7 notes. 8th note is, once again, whenever we tell Sa, Ri, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni, once again we tell Sa. Sa, Ri, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni, Sa. So, 8 is repeating as 1. 8 and 1 are repeating. So, every 8th element shows the similar property. It is similar to the notes of a music. Notes of a music. So that is why 8. So which is being used as the 8 element system. So the elements when they are arranged in the order of their increasing atomic weight, every eighth element, then let's make good, both answer is correct for the previous choice. So this eighth element and first element, every eighth element and the first element in the arrangement of Neumann's Neumann's collection of elements, they have similarity. So eighth note of musical scale is similar to the first note. Eighth note is also sa, first note is also sa. So eighth note is similar to, it is like the first note. Sa, ri, ga, ma, pa, da, ni. Once again, eighth note is sa. So that is similar to that. Here also, elements are present in the, now this is the octave is the collection of eight elements, collection of seven element, eighth element will be similar. Lithium 1, beryllium 2, boron 3, carbon 4th. I am mentioning the number of the element, not the atomic number. First element lithium, second element beryllium, third element boron, fourth element carbon, fifth element nitrogen, sixth element oxygen, seventh element fluorine, but eighth element sodium. If lithium is the first element, sodium is the eighth element. If sodium is the first element, potassium is the eighth element. Potassium is the eighth element. Similarly, beryllium first element means magnesium eighth element. Magnesium first element means eighth element calcium, like that. So first and eighth elements are respectively boron and aluminium, carbon and silicon, nitrogen and phosphorus, oxygen and sulfur, fluorine and chlorine. So he observed lithium, sodium, potassium, all these are metals, they form salts, lithium chloride, sodium chloride, potassium sulfate, like that. Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, these are forming alkaline earth metals, you will see them later. Boron, aluminium, these are they will have a valency of 3. First group has a valency of, so by now everybody please make a note, what is mean by valency, but I have studied in your lower classes. Valency is the combining capacity, the number of atoms with which a particular atom combines. For example, valency of helium is 0, because helium will not combine with any element. Valency of hydrogen is 1, because hydrogen is connected to one chlorine atom. If you take the methane, hydrogen is connected to only carbon atom. Carbon valency is 4, because carbon is connected to 4 different hydrogen atoms. So valency is the number of atoms with which a particular atom is connected. So here, first one, lithium, sodium, potassium, they show a valency of 2. Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, they show a valency of, lithium, sodium, potassium, they show a valency of 1. Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, they show a, for example, magnesium chloride formula is MgCl2. Sodium chloride formula NaCl, because sodium is connected to only one chlorine atom. Magnesium is connected to two chlorine atoms. So aluminium chloride formula AlCl3. Well, aluminium is connected to 3 chlorine atoms. Methane, carbon is connected to 4 hydrogen atoms. Methane formula, carbon is connected to 4 hydrogen atoms. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Maximum valency can be 4 only. Once again, it decreases. Nitrogen valency is 3. Ammonia, nitrogen combines with 3 hydrogen atoms. Oxygen valency is 2. H2O. Oxygen combines with two hydrogen atoms. Oxygen combines with two hydrogen atoms. Once again, fluorine, chlorine, these are valencies one. Sodium chloride, hydrogen fluoride, sodium chloride. So, valency initially increases and then decreases. So, I could see some poor favorable and again for and against type of comments symbolically. If you have any doubt, you can raise. Now, this essence of this one, that is Lothermeyer periodic table, every Newman's law of octave states that every eighth element shows a similar one. But once again, it drawbacks of Newman's law of octaves. Once again, it some certain properties they are not repeating. They are not repeating. We will see. This law of octaves holds good only up to calcium. You can see the periodic table. The first two columns, three elements are there: lithium, sodium, potassium. Second column, beryllium, magnesium, calcium. But third column onwards, only two elements: boron and aluminium, carbon and silicon, nitrogen and phosphorus, oxygen and sulfur. But third element is not mentioned here. Why it is not mentioned? Not that there is no element. There is a compound, there is an element bromine, there is an element selenium, there is an element arsenic, there is an element germanium, there is an element gallium. These are there, but they are not mentioned here because they do not follow the Newland's law. So Newland's law is not applicable beyond calcium. Is not applicable beyond calcium. What is the limitation of Newland's law? Newland's law is applicable only up to calcium. You have to know that. The question will arise. What is the limitation of Newland's law? Newland's law is applicable only up to calcium. So, beyond calcium, Newland's law does not hold good. So, it is not there. Lastly, so far, first two people, they arrange the elements only in the row of three elements or eight elements. Lothermeyer arranged the elements in the form of rows and columns based on their atomic weights. How he plotted? He plotted the physical properties. What are the properties? Atomic volume, volume of one oxygen atom, volume of one sodium atom, melting point of sodium, melting point of lithium, melting point of gallium, like that, boiling point. So he chose the properties such as atomic volume, melting point, boiling point. All these were taken in y-axis. X-axis is always atomic weights. X-axis is always atomic weight. Y-axis, atomic volume or melting point or boiling point. He could draw some graph. Accordingly, he arranged the elements. That was the this arrangement. Lothermeyer periodic table. What is the source? Is that in this way he has arranged. With this, you can see today's class. We will see the introduction and we will limit. Please wait for a while. And really, there was a power cut. So Newland's arranged the element in the order of their increasing dash. Questions, multiple choice questions. Newland's, you can try. Newland's had arranged the element in the order of their increasing atomic number, atomic weight. Both, none. Which is correct? It is atomic weight. It is, just now we have seen, he arranged this one against atomic weight. against atomic weight. So he arranged in the form of atomic weight. Good. Choice B. So this is one. Not Stefanio, it is not both. It is based on only Stefanio, please make a note. It is based on only atomic weights. Only atomic weight. It is not both. Also for Pulakit Gowda, it is neither. None of means neither atomic weight nor that is not correct. It is based on only atomic weight. So everybody, the atomic weight, previous slide, boiling point against atomic weight is to be noted. So good evening, Shiba. Now this we have seen. So elements when arranged in the order of their increasing atomic weight, that is to be noted. Atomic weight. Every eighth element had the properties of similar to that of the first element. We have seen. Next, what is meant by octave? Octa, octa means which digit? 5, 3, whatever be the case. 6, 7, 8. Octa means 8. Octave means collection of 8 elements. Collection of 8 elements. So octave means 8 elements in the system. System of 8 elements. Good. Kandiba. Serena. Nice. So third one. Validity. Up to which element is applicable? Newland's law of octave. Everybody nice. 8. So Newland's law of octave is observed up to sodium, potassium, calcium. Nice. Serena. Calcium, chlorine. So it is valid up to calcium. So even though they are given as multiple choice questions, these are the standard questions to be in on your pattern. It will be mentioned. First part, first few questions are MCQ. All these will be there. Good. So it is valid up to only calcium. Everybody nice. So this one. Now we can have a brief introduction about the Mendeleev's periodic table. We will see them in detail. Mendeleev, already we have seen, noted that Mendeleev arranged the elements in the form of this one, that is the form of rows and columns according to the atomic weight only. According to the atomic weight, he placed some empty spaces for the future element during his lifetime. That is the peculiarity. So Mendeleev, so here also atomic weights. What is the Mendeleev? This slide shows the, in your book it will be mentioned, or you can note what is Mendeleev's periodic law. Mendeleev's periodic law is that properties of the elements are periodic functions of their atomic weights. What is meant by periodic functions? They repeat according to atomic weight. Repeat according to atomic weight. So Mendeleev periodic law. What is Mendeleev's periodic law? The properties of the elements are periodic functions. Sine function is a periodic function because sine 2 pi plus theta equal to sine theta. Tan 2 pi plus theta equal to tan theta. Like that. Here also, every regular interval, in every regular interval, properties getting repeated based on the atomic weights. So this is the essence of the periodic law. So this is called short form of periodic table. He arranged the elements in the form of a square, roughly square, equivalent to square. But whereas a mostly periodic table, long rectangular arrangement. We will see them in detail. So it is called short form of periodic table. Mendeleev's periodic table is called short form of periodic table. So Mendeleev, essence for today's class, Mendeleev and Lothar Mayer published identical classification schemes. The periodic table is based on the similarity of properties and reactivities exhibited by certain elements. later on mostly revised. So the same law, periodic law, Mendeleev periodic law means atomic weight, Moseley's periodic law means atomic number. These two are carefully to be noted. Very often will be asked, what is Mendeleev's periodic law, what is Moseley's periodic law? Statement is almost same. That is the elements. Mendeleev's, once again to repeat, Mendeleev's periodic law is that properties of the elements are periodic functions of their atomic weights. Whereas Lothermeyer periodic table, we will see Lothermeyer periodic table, it is applicable, that is also applicable only up to calcium, can't be banned. Drawback of Lothermeyer and Newman's law, common, that is also applicable only up to calcium. So even though elements after calcium were detected, property was, were not repeating to calcium. So Moseley's or modern periodic law is that properties of the elements are periodic functions of their atomic number. So if you write weight, Mendeleev's law. If you write number, it is Moseley's law. Same, one and the same statement, except for a word. You have to carefully note down. So atomic number. So here Mendeleev's periodic table arranged helium, hydrogen. Let me read the thing, may not be visible. Let me read the thing. First row or first period, helium, hydrogen, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. Whereas first group or vertical column, helium, argon, krypton, xenon, like that. But it goes well up to first, this is called zeroth group. This is called zeroth group. First group, second group, third group, like that. It goes groups of elements up to eighth group. But in the free way, up to seventh group, they are in a particular square or particular row and column arrangement, only one or two elements will be there, nitrogen and phosphorus, oxygen and sulfur, fluorine and chlorine. Maximum two elements will be there, tantalum and bismuth, tungsten only. One or two elements will only be there up to seventh group. But in the eighth group, there are more than two elements. They have similar properties, they cannot be properly placed. So eighth group elements in the fourth and five, iron, cobalt, according to Mendeleev's periodic table. So iron, cobalt, nickel, also copper. Four elements are there here. But next group, Mendeleev's period, ruthenium, rhodium, palladium, silver. Here also four elements. Lastly, osmium, iridium, platinum, gold. Here also four elements. So here, zeroth law. Sherina told about, asked about zeroth law. Zeroth law comes in a different chapter, thermodynamics. That we will see later. Here it is called zeroth group. Zeroth law, let me check if it is there. I will tell. So as far as this chapter is concerned, zeroth law is not there. Modern periodic law, Mendeleev's law, Newman's law, it is named after the respective scientists. Law of octaves, like that. Zeroth law comes only in the thermodynamics. We will see them. Anyhow, let me check. So the vertical columns are called groups. Horizontal rows are called periods. Horizontal rows of elements are called periods in the Mendeleev's as well as. Each group is divided into two groups, subgroups. So first group means first A and first B. Second group means second A and second B, but not zeroth group. 0A and 0B, no. Eighth group also 8A and 8B, as per the period, Mendeleev's periodic table. So except for 0 and 8th group, 0th group,
and eighth group, all other groups are divided into two types groups, subgroup A, subgroup B. So I will see what is mean by transition element. At present, note that you might have shown what is the formula for iron. Anybody can write what is the formula for iron chloride? Anybody can write what is the formula for iron chloride? Iron chloride, there are two formula, FeCl2, FeCl3. This is FeCl2 is called ferrous chloride. With this we can limit. FeCl2 is called ferrous chloride. FeCl3 is called ferric chloride. Both are called iron chloride. One is called iron 2 chloride, iron 3 chloride. Two chlorine atoms. Here valency of iron is 2. Here valency of iron is 3. So if the valency changes from one value to other value, such elements are called transition elements. So group 8, iron, cobalt, nickel, ruthenium, rhodium, palladium, silver, osmium, iridium, platinum, gold. All these have different valencies. Different valencies. So the valency changes means the such type of elements are called transition elements. We will see them in detail. Today we have ended up to Mendeleev's periodic table. Next class we will see the Moseley's periodic table. Already I have told what is the merit. It is important. What is the merit of Mendeleev's periodic table? He gave an elaborate classification based on the physical as well as chemical property. Lothermeyer, once you go, what is the drawback of Lothermeyer? Kahn, Deben, you go raise the question. Lothermeyer drawback is that he compared only the physical properties. Here, Mendeleev compared both physical and chemical properties. What is meant by chemical property? Chemical property means reactivity, acidic, basic, like that. So pH, all these chemical properties are considered. Whereas density, mass, these are physical properties. So the drawback with the Lothermeyer is that comparison only with the physical properties of the elements. Here he compared merit of that physical and chemical properties. As I told already, he predicted the existence of unknown elements and left some gaps as the naming them as eka elements, eka boron, eka aluminium. In Greek, eka means similar to boron, similar to aluminium, like that. Example, scandium he called during the period of Mendeleev, during the lifetime of Mendeleev, scandium was not invented or discovered. He called scandium, but he has predicted the atomic weight of scandium. See, he told that there is an element with atomic weight 44.1. It is called eka boron. Later on it was named as scandium. And also he did not, during his lifetime, during the lifetime of Mendeleev, gallium is a liquid metal. Everybody make a note. There are two important liquid metals. One is mercury, another one is gallium. Gallium and mercury are liquid metals. Metals in the normal temperature, they are liquids, but they are metals. So gallium was not discovered during the period of Mendeleev, but he told that there is an element with atomic weight 70.0. later on it was observed as gallium. So he called gallium as eka aluminium because gallium resembles aluminium in many properties. Aluminium is also lightweight. Gallium is also lightweight. Aluminium is also a bright metal. Gallium is also a bright metal. But there is a difference. Aluminium is a solid. Gallium is a liquid. So you cannot always tell. Everything is not same. There will be similarities. That is meant by, that is the aspect of this one. Lastly, germanium. During the lifetime of Mendeleev, I have told accidentally Mendeleevium. There was one element In honor of Mendeleev, it was named as Mendeleevium. You will see them later. So germanium was not discovered during the period of Mendeleev, but he told that the element, there is an element with atomic weight 72.3. He called that as eco silicon. Silicon is a semiconductor. Germanium is also semiconductor. He told that its conductivity is low. That's all. So that is the, he correct the atomic weights of beryllium and indium, other merit. So this property, you got this formula, you got to note down. Atomic weight equal to equivalent weight into valency. Atomic weight equal to equivalent weight into valency. Making use of these properties, he corrected the atomic weights of beryllium and indium based on their beryllium atomic weight as 9.1, indium atomic weight correctly calculated. So these are the merits. Demerits is that some elements with higher atomic weight, generally if you arrange the elements, increasing order of atomic weights will be there. A, B, C, if they are arranged, atomic weight of A is less than B, is less than C, it should be like that. But there were some elements which was against this ascending order. Example is that, with this we can limit. You can compare argon and Mendeleev periodic table. In your book, both the periodic tables are mentioned, Mendeleev and mostly. Argon has the atomic weight of 39.9, whereas potassium has the atomic weight of 39.1. 39.1 is less than 39.9. Therefore, potassium should come first, argon should come next. But he has mentioned argon first and potassium next. So he did not change the series. He could not explain, that's all. He could not explain he exactly placed. So the it is based on the atomic weight is somewhat different. That's all. Similar such opposite example to Mendeleev's law, cobalt and nickel with atomic weights 58.9 and 58.7. Cobalt is placed before nickel, even though its atomic weight is higher. They will ask everybody, note down the example of cobalt and nickel at least. They will ask the example. What is the example that goes against the Mendeleev's law? Cobalt and nickel. Cobalt and nickel. And lastly, tellurium and iodine. Te is tellurium. I is iodine. Hereafter, in your book, you can have a glance over the name of the elements in your book. In the second chapter as well as third chapter, every element is mentioned, name of the elements. You should have mean a position to identify. What is Te? Te is tellurium. I is iodine. So tellurium is having a atomic weight of 127.6, whereas iodine has atomic weight of 126.9. So lower atomic weight species iodine is kept later. These are the drawbacks. With this we can limit. Anybody having doubt, you can raise. So tomorrow, next class, in the next class, you can see the mostly periodic table in detail.